Okay, so if I go to the documentation and start writing navigation controller, Xcode auto completes it for me. It says here that the navigation interface makes it possible to present your data efficiently and makes it easier for the user to navigate that content. So that seems that UI navigation controller will help me navigate between two different screens on my app. Cool. Okay, so if I go back to Storyboard, I can see that the first screen of my app is right here. To add another one, I can open up Utilities and add a new view controller from this list. Notice that we are adding a view controller in this case. All right, I'm going to slide out the utility area and then arrange these view controllers properly. So here I have the first screen of my app. And imagine that this new view controller, which for now is empty, is going to contain a view which will display the second screen of my app. This screen is going to have all of the buttons that will allow us to play sounds. For now, all I want to do is connect this stop button to this new view controller. Now, the way to do this is to press and hold Control on your keyboard and then drag from the stop button onto the new view controller. This will present a bunch of options called segues. You can think of segues as transitions between these two view controllers, almost like transitions between two different slides in a presentation. I will select Show. Okay, so the two view controllers are connected. At this point, I'm going to try and run the app and see if it even works. I'm going to press the microphone button. All right, the recording label and the stop button start to show up correctly. So far, so good. What happens after I click the stop button? Hey, here's the second screen of our app. And I also have the back button. And when I click that, I can go back to the first screen. Let me try one more time. This seems to be working. All right, so there are a couple of things I want to do back in the storyboard. I can add a title here and then try to run the app again. All right, so you'll notice that the title of the first screen has changed. And then if I try to go to the second screen, the back button there has also changed. Brilliant. By the way, all of this back and forth navigation, this top bar and the back button, all of this was accomplished by this UI navigation controller right here. So let's think about this a little bit more deeply.